Welcome to my channel. Today we are going to discuss about the MCQ question from the unit 4 finite wall length effect. So already I posted one video for the fourth unit, part number 14. So this is the next video. So in this video we are going to see about the topic number representation. Okay, so the fixed point, floating point, number representation. So from that question we will see some of the objective question. So the first question, what is the binary representation of the decimal number 6.25? So already, how to convert the decimal number into binary representation. So here you see 6.25. So here the first six, okay. So that integer part, the six, you just divide, you have to convert into binary. So you know the method, you have to divide by two. So if we are dividing, we will get 3. Then the remainder is 0. Similarly, you have to divide this quotient by again 2. So we will get the quotient is 1, the remainder is 1. So the binary representation for the number 6, you just write in this order 1, 1, 0. Okay. So here, and the remaining, the fractional part, you see 0.25. So we have to convert the 0.25 into corresponding binary representation. So you know the method, this 0.25 is multiplied with 2. Okay. So 0.25 multiplied with 2 means we will get 0.5. Okay, 0.5. Then the next one, again, we will get the fractional part only. So this fractional part 0.5 again multiplied with 2. So we will get the answer is 1.0. So we have to do this process till we will get the fractional part is 0. So here we will get the thing. And in this thing, so you just write this whole number as an answer. So what is the thing? 0, 1. So the 0.25 corresponding binary representation is 0.01. And the binary representation for the number 6 is 110. So totally the binary representation for the 6.25 is 110.01. Okay, so in a similar way, you just convert any decimal number into corresponding binary representation. Okay, then the next one, 111.01. So this binary number is equal to the decimal number x. Then what is the value of x? Okay, so here the question is, this question is reverse as that of the previous question. So here the decimal number is given. The question is we have to find the binary representation. So in this, the binary number is given. We have to find the corresponding decimal representation. So binary to decimal conversion. So already you studied this thing in digital electronics. Okay, in second year paper you studied. So how to convert this 111.01 into the decimal. So already you know that is this one. Okay, so this point nearer to one, this one. This one is multiplied with 2 to the power 0. Okay, then this one is multiplied with 2 to the power 1. Then this one is multiplied with 2 to the power 2. Similarly, after point, this 0 is multiplied with 2 to the power minus 1. Then this one is multiplied with 2 to the power minus 2. So you see the answer, this one most significant bit, 1 into 2 to the power 2 plus 1 into 2 to the power 1 plus 1 into 2 to the power 0 plus 0 into 2 to the power minus 1 plus 1 into 2 to the power minus 2. So if you are adding these value, we will get 7.25. So 7.25 is the answer. So this is the binary to decimal representation. Okay, conversion. Then next question, what are the different types of number representation used in digital computer or digital hardware? So we are using the different type of number representation. So here, what are the different types of representation in digital computer or digital hardware? So there are three methods are there: fixed point representation, floating point representation, block floating point representation. These are the three representation of number in a digital computer or digital hardware. Okay, then the next question. In fixed point arithmetic, the binary digit is fixed. Okay, binary digit is fixed. That is, the bit to the right represent the fractional part, and those to the left represent the integer part. It's a true or false. It's a true. Okay, so you see this one. Okay, is the 6.25. So how we are representing this 6.25 into the corresponding binary representation? So in fixed point representation, this point is, this binary point is fixed. Okay, so left part, it is used to represent this whole part, and the right part of this binary digit is used to represent the fractional part. Okay, so in fixed point arithmetic, the binary digit is fixed. The bit to the right used to represent fractional part, to the left represent integer part. It's a true. Then the next thing, what are the different forms of representing negative number in fixed point arithmetic? So in fixed point arithmetic, what are the different types of methods are there? Means one is sign magnitude form, one's complement form, two's complement form. So these are all the three methods in order to represent the negative number in fixed point arithmetic. Okay, then the next question, in sign magnitude form, the most significant bit, that is MSB. MSB is one to represent negative sign. It's a true or false? Yes. Okay, in sign magnitude representation, so for example, you see the next question, that is here the question is that what is the sign magnitude representation of the decimal number -1.75. okay, so first one, you just convert this 1.75 into corresponding binary digit. In order to represent this negative sign, the MSB, the most significant bit, we have to put one. Okay, so that is the thing. So in sign magnitude representation, the most significant bit is compulsory one in order to indicate the given number is a negative number. If it is a positive number, the most significant bit is zero. Okay, for example, if the number is that is minus six means, okay, so you know the six is nothing but 1 1 0, it is called as plus six. So in order to represent negative value, so again the most significant bit we have to put, it is a one. Okay, so that is a sign magnitude form. Then what is the sign magnitude representation of a decimal number -1.75? okay, it's a 11.11000, 01.11000. So yay, that is the one, the first, the one is represented by the number one, and 0.75 it is represented by 0.11, remainings are zero. Okay, so in order to represent as a negative number, the most significant bit, okay, this is the MSB, the most significant bit, we have to put one. So this is the sign magnitude representation of -1.75. Similarly, the next question, what is the sign magnitude representation of the decimal number +1.75? So +1.75 means, so this is the 1.75 representation. So the most significant bit, it is zero. Okay, so that means the zero is there or not, that's the same thing. 1.11, it's the answer. The next question, what is the one's complement representation of -0.875? Okay, so one's complement representation. So you know, one's complement and two's complement representation is used to represent the negative numbers. So in one's complement representation, so first we have to convert the binary representation of the given digit 0.875. okay, then in order to represent in one's complement, so you just convert the zeros are converted into ones and ones are converted into zeros. Okay, so that's why the answer is 1.000111. okay, similarly, what is the ones complement representation of 0.875? okay, this is plus number, so the answer is 0.11111000. this is the ones complement representation of this number. That is, in ones complement form, the positive number is represented in sign magnitude. Okay, the negative numbers are represented by complementing all bits to the positive. That is, zeros are converted to ones and ones are converted into zeros. So you see, in ones complement form, the positive number is represented in sign magnitude notation, but a negative number is obtained by complementing all bits of the positive number. Yes, it's a true. Okay, in order to represent positive number in ones complement form, we have to use the sign magnitude representation. Okay, the negative numbers are represented by, we have to take complement for all positive numbers. Okay, that is, for this, if we want to get a ones complement of -0.875, first we have to represent 0.875, and the answer is 0.1110. Then this digit, you just take ones complement. That is, zeros are converted to ones, ones are converted to zero. So that's why you will get the answer like this. Okay. The next thing, in twos complement form, the positive number is represented in sign magnitude and ones complement, but the negative number is obtained by complementing all bits of the positive number and adding one to the LSB. This is true. Yes. Okay. In twos complement representation, if it is a positive number, that number is represented in either sign magnitude or ones complement. Okay. The negative number is obtained by, first we have to take ones complement, then we have to add one to the LSB of that complemented answer. That is the twos complement form. Okay. So you see, what is that twos complement representation of -0.875? So first one, you know, the first step is to, for 0.875, we have to write a binary representation. So already, you know, for 0.875, the binary representation is 0.111000. Okay. This is the thing means, then you just take the ones complement of this first step. So 1.000111. Then we have to add one to that particular answer. So we will get the answer is 1.001000. Okay. So this is the twos complement representation. Twos complement is nothing but the ones complement answer added with one. Okay. Added with one in LSB. Then what is the twos complement of 1100? Okay. So for this binary number, what is the twos complement means? First, we have to take ones complement. Ones complement is nothing but the zero is replaced by one, one is replaced by zero. So for 1100, we will get 0011. Okay. Then for this ones complement answer, we have to add one. So 1 + 1, 0. The remainder is one. Okay. Then 1 + 1, 0. The remainder one. So 1, 0. So the answer is 0100. Okay. This is the twos complement of this particular number. Then the next thing, in a ones complement form, okay, in ones complement form, the magnitude of negative number is given by. So what is the formula in order to calculate the magnitude of the negative number? Okay, so the magnitude of negative number is calculated by 1 minus summation I equal to 1 to b ci 2 to the power minus I minus 2 to the power minus b, where b is a number of bits used to represent that particular number. So this is the formula in order to calculate the magnitude of the negative number in ones complement form. Okay, so you just review this formula. Then the next question, in a twos complement form, the magnitude of negative number is given by dash. So in twos complement form, the magnitude of negative number is given by 1 minus summation I equal to 1 to b ci 2 to the power minus I. So this is the formula in order to find the magnitude of negative number in a twos complement form. Okay, so these are all the questions from the fixed point representation. Then this next form of representation, it's a floating point representation. So, you know, in fixed point representation, the digit, the binary digit is fixed. So we can decide, that is, in order to indicate the integer part, how many digits we have to take. In order to indicate the fractional part, how many digits we have to take. It is fixed in fixed point representation. Okay, the next type of representation, it is floating point representation. So in floating point representation, That is the number used to represent the integer part and the fractional part is floating, varying. That is a floating point representation. So in floating point representation, the positive number is represented in the form of the number f equal to floating point number equal to 2 to the power c into m, where m is a mantissa, c is an exponent. Okay, so this is the general form of floating point representation, whereas m is the mantissa. The mantissa, it's a fraction. Okay, so the value of mantissa, it should be in between 0.5 to 1. The m value between greater than 0.5, it should be less than 1. And c is the exponent. So the c is the exponent. The exponent, either it is a positive or negative. The exponent, c is an exponent. Either it may be positive or negative. Okay. So this is a true or false. True. Okay. In floating point representation, any number, any positive number can be represented as f equal to 2 to the power c into m, where m is a mantissa, c is an exponent. The condition for mantissa is the m value between 0.5 to 1. The value of the exponent, it should be positive or negative. So you see, in floating point representation, the mantissa is a fraction such that in between 0.5 to 1, it's a true. Okay. Then which of the following is correct representation of floating point number x? Okay. So already you know the number, floating point number is represented by mantissa into 2 to the power exponent. Okay. This is the correct representation, where m is between 1 by 2 to 1. Okay, then the next question, what is the resolution to cover a range of number x max minus x min with b number of bits? Okay, so the resolution or, okay, the resolution or in order to cover a range of number x max minus x min with b number of bits is x max minus x min divided by 2 to the power b minus 1. So this is the resolution formula. Okay, if the signal x is having the maximum value x max, minimum value x min, b is the number of bit, means the resolution is x max minus s min divided by 2 to the power b minus 1. This is the formula. Then what are the mantissa and exponent required respectively in order to represent 4.5? in a binary floating point representation? Okay, so for the decimal number 4.5, what is the floating point representation? So in order to represent the floating point, that is a mantissa and exponent, we have to find out. So first one, this 4.5, okay, the decimal number you just divide by 2. Okay, so up to which one we have to divide means we will get the quotient as a flow, that is a fraction part. Okay, so first 4.5 divided by 2, we will get 2.25. So in this, the integer is there, fraction is also there. Again, this 2.25, you just divide by 2. So 1.125. Again, the whole part is there, the fraction is there. Again, this number you just divide by 2. So 0.5625. So here you see, here the integer is not available. Okay. So how many times we divided this decimal number to get this fractional part? 3 times. Okay, so that's why the 2 to the power m, okay, the value, that is in floating point representation. So you see, in floating point representation, any number can be represented as 2 to the power c into m, where c is a exponent. So that exponent value, okay, so that the exponent value, the c is equal to 3. The 3 is nothing but how many times we divided the given number to get the fractional part. Okay, so here the exponent c is equal to 3. Okay, and the remaining, this 0.5625, it is a mantissa. So already you know the mantissa, the condition for mantissa is that this answer, it should be greater than 0.5, it should be less than 1. Yes, here the mantissa 0.5625 is greater than 0.5, less than 1. So that's why the 4.5, it is represented by 2 to the power 3 into 0.5625. Okay, so this is the floating point representation of the number 4.5. Okay, and the next one, we have to convert in binary form. So this exponent e equal to 3. So the exponent 3, you just represent in binary form. Okay, so you just represent it binary form. If you are converting the 3 into binary form, we will get 0, 1, 1. Similarly, 0.5625, you just convert into binary, we will get 0.1001 in a hash shell method. So this is the answer. So here, mantissa and exponent. Okay, so the mantissa is 0.1001. Okay, so this is, then this one is exponent. So the answer A. Okay, 0, 1, 1 is the exponent. This is the mantissa. Then the next question, what are the mantissa and exponent required in order to represent the number 5 in binary floating point representation? Okay, so in floating point representation, so the number 5, okay, the number 5, it can be written as 2 to the power 3 into 0.625. Okay, so we can write, so 5, you just divide by 2, we will get 2.5. Again, 2.5 divided by 2, 1.25. Then 1.25 divided by 2, we will get 0.625. Okay, so the number 5, it can be represented as 2 to the power 3 into 0.625. Okay, so here, this 0.625, it's a mantissa, it's an exponent. So 3, if you are representing binary, 0, 1, 1. 0.625, if you are representing, we will get 0.10100. So the answer, this D is the answer. Okay, this representation is called floating point representation. Then next question, if two numbers are to be multiplied, mantissa are multiplied and exponents are added, it's a true or false? It's a true. Okay, when we are adding, if we want to add two numbers, okay, two floating point numbers, the mantissa, it should be multiplied. The exponent, it should be added. Okay, for example, you see, consider two number x equal to m into 2 to the power e, y equal to n into 2 to the power f. Okay, here, if you are multiplying x and y, this mantissa m and n, you just multiply. This exponent value, 2 to the power value, you just add. So the statement is true. Then the next question, what is the largest floating point number that can be represented using 32-bit word? Okay, so using 32-bit word, what is the largest floating point number we can represent? So the largest floating point number is 1.7 into 10 to the power 38. Okay. So this is the largest floating point number that can be represented using 32-bit word. Okay. Then the next question, if exponent is 0 and mantissa is also 0, then which of the following statement is true about the number x? Okay. If for one number, exponent 0, mantissa 0 means what about the value of that particular number? So that number is also, the number is a 0 number. For if x is 0, the exponent is also 0 and the mantissa is also 0. Okay, so these are all the some of the questions from the number representation in a digital computer or a digital hardware. Okay, so what are the two type of binary representation means? Fixed point representation and floating point. The third one is block floating point representation. Okay, so thanks for watching my channel. And please subscribe my channel for more videos. If you want to learn the remaining 14 videos for this MCQ or DTSP or a digital signal processing MCQ, I will give link in the description box. You can see, or in my channel, the discrete time signal processing playlist, all videos are available in order. You can see. Okay, so we will meet in the next video. Thank you.